Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 54th episode of Beautiful Minds with me, Kirti.
Wow.
It's a live chat show with unsung heroines around the world. And today I have with me Priya Abhishek Joseph. She is a hair and makeup artist and a passionate, I should say, photographer, or she is so passionate about photography and advocacy. So we're going to learn a lot of things from her, as well as we're going to learn, know about her story as well. So welcome, Priya, to my show.
Thank you, Casey. Thank you for having me.
Wonderful. Priya, let's move on, Priya. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു ആൾക്കാരെ മിക്കവാറും പ്രിയ അഭിഷേക് ജോസഫ് ഹെയർ സ്റ്റൈലിസ്റ്റ് എന്നൊക്കെ പറയുമ്പോൾ ഭയങ്കര സംഭവമാണ്, ദൈവമേ നമുക്കൊന്നും അറിയാത്ത ഒരാളാന്നൊക്കെ വിചാരിക്കും. ബട്ട് ഐ എം ഷുവർ ദാറ്റ് ഫോർ ദി ഓഡിയൻസ് അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് ഫ്യൂ ഓഫ് ദം യു നോ ഹർ, ബട്ട് സ്റ്റിൽ ദർ ആർ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് തിങ്സ് വിച്ച് വിൽ നോ അബൌട്ട് പ്രിയ ടുഡേ. സോ മൂവിംഗ് ഓൺ പ്രിയ, നമുക്ക് നമ്മുടെ ചെറുപ്പകാലം മുതൽ തുടങ്ങാം. ടെൽ അസ് സംതിങ് അബൌട്ട് യുവർ ചൈൽഡ്ഹുഡ്, ലൈക്ക് വേർ വേർ യു ആൻഡ് ഹൗ ഡിഡ് യു ഡു യുവർ സ്റ്റഡീസ്, ഹൗ ഡിഡ് യു നോ ടേൺ അപ് ടു ബി എ മേക്കപ്പ് ആർട്ടിസ്റ്റ്? ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ഹാവ് ജസ്റ്റ് മെസ്സേജ് ഇൻ ദ പോസ്റ്റ് ദാറ്റ് she was so much passionate about makeup, and that's how she turned her career like that. So today actually Priya was facing some glitch there.
I have trouble with it's been tripping, so I'm not even going to switch it on. I'm not going to switch it on because it will keep happening, and then it will keep moving between the Wi-Fi and the 4G. So I'm just going to work with the 4G now. It's going to be hot.
I should definitely say this. Yeah, I should definitely say this before we go ahead, that you look more beautiful in this light right now, because, you know, that the red color, the black and the light. I think I need to probably add some extra light on my face so that I can actually compliment you on the other side.
I was just saying
that, Priya, let's talk about from your childhood days. Let people know about how things went on with you, and how did you actually land up into a career which is being a makeup artist and someone who's so passionate about photography. So let's go back to childhood days of Priya. Priya, let's move on.
So I am the second of four girls. We're four daughters. And I was born in Bombay. So I've been born and raised outside Kerala. I was born in Bombay, there for the first 5 years of my life, in Delhi for 2 years, and my family moved to Bangalore in 1987. And my parents are settled in the city, you know, and two of my sisters live over there. So I completed most of my education in Bangalore. I finished my schooling in Bangalore. I did my plus two and my bachelor's in Bangalore. And then I went to Chennai for my master's. I did psychology, literature, and communications, and I went on to do a master's in journalism and communication. So yeah, so I've been actually, in like the major cities, lived in the major cities, and I've always considered myself a city girl. And so that's a little bit about my childhood, you know, so where I kind of lived. Yeah.
So I hope that the audience right now understand that why did I switch on our language, the mode of language, so English, because Priya is much more comfortable with English. പക്ഷെ മലയാളികളാകുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് എപ്പോഴും ഒരു പുതിയ ഉണ്ടാവും, അല്ലെ, ഒരു ചെറിയ മലയാളം വാക്കൊക്കെ എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ ഒന്ന് പറഞ്ഞൂടെ എന്നുള്ളത്. പ്രിയ, വുഡ് യു ജസ്റ്റ് ലെറ്റ് അസ് നോ ദാറ്റ് റൈറ്റ്? പിന്നല്ല, നമ്മളങ്ങനെ പൊളിക്കുകയാണ്. ഇനി ജോലി സംതിങ് വേർ യു റൈറ്റ്? അതായത് നമ്മൾ എവിടെയാണ് ഇപ്പോൾ ഉള്ളതെന്നുള്ളതൊന്നും മലയാളത്തിൽ പറഞ്ഞ ആൾക്കാർക്ക് ഓ നമ്മുടെ ആളാണല്ലേ എന്ന് തോന്നി ചിലപ്പോ.
പിന്നെ ലൈക്ക് സോ ഐ ഞാൻ മലയാളിയാണ്, ആൻഡ് ഐ ബിൻ ലിവിംഗ് ഇൻ കൊച്ചി ഞാൻ സിൻസ് 2013, mid-2013, I started doing hair and makeup in Cochin. And honestly, I've grown in so many ways as a woman, as a liberated woman in Kerala, which I never imagined, you know. So, എനിക്ക് മലയാളത്തിൽ സംസാരിക്കാൻ, യു നോ, ലൈക്ക് എനിക്ക് കുറച്ച് നാണാണ്, ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ഹാഡ് പീപ്പിൾ ടീസിംഗ് മീ ഇൻ ദ പാസ്റ്റ്. സോ ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ എന്റെ ആക്സെന്റ് അത്ര വളരെ നല്ലതല്ല.
ഓഡിയൻസ് പ്ലീസ് ട്രോൾ ഇറക്കരുത്, ബിക്കോസ് ദിസ് ഇസ് ജസ്റ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഷീ ഹാസ് ഡൺ ഓൾ ഹർ സ്റ്റഡീസ് ഇൻ എവറിഥിങ് ഔട്ട്സൈഡ് കേരള. അപ്പൊ അതുകൊണ്ട് ഈ കേരളത്തിലുള്ള പല ആൾക്കാരും എന്നെ മലയാളം പറയുന്നത് കേൾക്കുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് ഞെട്ടും. അപ്പൊ ഇനി പ്രിയ പറയണ കിട്ടുമെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങള് ഓ വലിയ ജാടാന്ന് വിചാരിക്കും, ഇത് ജാടയല്ല മക്കളെ, ഇത് ഇങ്ങനെ വന്നു പോകുന്നതാണ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് സ്വിച്ച് ഓൺ ടു ദ ലാംഗ്വേജ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഇറ്റ്സെൽഫ്, ബിക്കോസ് ഐ വോണ്ട് ടു മേക്ക് മൈ ഗസ്റ്റ് കംഫർട്ടബിൾ ഹിയർ റാദർ ദാൻ പുട്ടിംഗ് ഹർ ഓൺ എ സ്പോട്ട്. Moving on, Priya, how did your love towards makeup and hairstyling actually turned out to be a career for you? Because you said that you have done a lot of things, like you have just stepped into every shoes, I would say. But then finally, you came up into one thing. I don't know whether did you have any thought that you would definitely land up your career as an artist like this?
No, I mean, I knew I would do something creative, because I've always been creatively inclined. When I was younger, actually, I wanted to study design, and my dad was like, he told me that njan ipo NID le Ahmedabad le NID avade admission kittiyal mathram enikku angote povan pattu. And when I did the entrance when I was 18, several years ago, ആ സമയത്ത് അത് ലൈക് 30,000 സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് റൈറ്റിംഗ് ഫോർ 30 സീറ്റ്സ് എനിക്ക് കിട്ടിയില്ല, സോ ദെൻ ആൻഡ് മൈ ഡാഡ് വാസ് വളരെ സ്ട്രിക്റ്റ് ആയിരുന്നു. സോ ഈ സർ വേറെ സ്ഥലത്തൊന്നും പഠിക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല, യു കാൻ സ്റ്റഡി ദിസ് എനിവെയർ എൽസ്. സോ മൈ ബാക്കപ്പ് വാസ് സ്റ്റഡിങ്. ഐവ് ഓൾവേസ് ബിൻ ഗുഡ് വിത്ത് മൈ ലിംഗ്വിസ്റ്റിക് സ്കിൽസ്. സോ അപ്പോ അങ്ങനെയാണ് ഐ ഓൾവേസ് ഹാഡ് എൻ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഇൻ സൈക്കോളജി ആസ് വെൽ. അപ്പൊ അങ്ങനെയാണ് ഞാൻ ഇങ്ങനെ ലൈക് ഇൻ ബാംഗ്ലൂർ യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി യു ഡു ട്രിപ്പിൾ മേജർ. അപ്പൊ അങ്ങനെയാണ് ലൈക് ഐ എൻഡഡ് അപ് ഡൂയിങ് ദോസ് സബ്ജെക്ട്സ്. ബട്ട് ഐവ് ഓൾവേസ് ബിൻ ക്രിയേറ്റീവ്ലി ഇൻക്ലൈൻഡ് ഫ്രം വെൻ ഐ വാസ് എ ചൈൽഡ്. ആൻഡ് അപ്പോ സോ ഞാൻ വെൻ ഐ മൂവ് ടു ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ലൈക്ക് എ വെരി ലോങ് വൈൻഡ് വേ ഓഫ് കമ്മിങ് അറൌണ്ട് ടു ഡൂയിങ് ഹെയർ ആൻഡ് മേക്കപ്പ്. അപ്പൊ ഞാൻ ഐ വർക്ക് ഓൺ ദ കോർപ്പറേറ്റ് സൈഡ്. ഞാൻ മാർക്കറ്റ് റിസർച്ചിലാണ് ജോലി ചെയ്തത്, ലൈക് ഫോർ എ കമ്പനി കോൾ നീൽസൺ. ഐ ലിവ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ യു കെ ഫോർ സം ഇയേഴ്സ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഗോട്ട് മാരിഡ്. അപ്പൊ അവിടെ ഐ സ്റ്റാർട്ട് വർക്കിംഗ് ഫോർ എ മാർക്കറ്റ് റിസർച്ച് ഫേം. വെൻ വി ഡിസൈഡ് ടു കം ബാക്ക് ടു ഇന്ത്യ, അത് ഞാൻ അതാണ് ചെയ്തത്. ഐ ഡിഡ് മാർക്കറ്റ് റിസർച്ച്. പിന്നെ കൊച്ചിയിലോട്ട് ഇവിടെ മാറിയപ്പോ ആണ് ഐ സെഡ് യു നോ ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് ടു ബി ഡൂയിങ് ദിസ് എനി മോർ. ഐ ഡെഫിനറ്റ്ലി വാണ്ട് ടു ഡു സംതിങ് ദാറ്റ് വിൽ യൂസ് മൈ ക്രിയേറ്റിവിറ്റി മോർ. ഐ തിങ്ക് ദാറ്റ്സ് വെയർ മൈ സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ലൈസ്. And apart from my strength, I also, it makes me happy. It doesn't feel like work when I'm doing something creative. It doesn't like, it does take a lot of energy. It can be exhausting, but it also gives me a lot of energy. It also gives me a lot of fulfillment. Appo, I was 34 when I decided to do hair and makeup. And it did take a little bit of convincing at the time, and when I told my husband about it. My older son was 4 years old then. Appo, I was like, how am I going to develop this credibility overnight? I don't have the luxury of my 20s to teach myself how to do this. And so I decided, njan Bombay poi avade oru course cheydu, rendu course cheydu, one for hair and one for makeup. Hair course was okay. I really liked the trainer. She was a very sincere person. Appo, I acquired some initial skills over there. Makeup was a complete waste of money. So I think a lot of people actually, I want to mention something. I have a lot of young women, messaging me. Have messaged me in the past saying, evadeyana poi hair and makeup padikkende. And it's unfortunate, but a lot of academies, utri kaash edukum. They take a lot of money to teach, telling you that they're going to teach you. But then that transfer of skills doesn't happen, and... So a lot, you end up losing a lot.
Yes, go on.
You can hear me, right?
Of course.
So that's just an aside. I just wanted to mention that. So you really need to be careful about this, I think if you're young, and you're interested in hair and makeup, it's just advisable to put all that money that you would put towards a course towards buying your own kit, buying your own makeup brushes, buying your own makeup. It is an expensive affair getting all of this product. But then, look at makeup artists' work who you admire, study their skills, get in touch with them. I wouldn't recommend going to an academy, to be honest. In India, I don't know, like a lot of... I can't really, I mean, there is some people in Cochin, there's somebody who offers like Cherrier Academy Anna face palette. I've not been, like, I haven't really studied with her, but I feel like she's a sincere person and she offers, like a basics course. I don't know how much it costs, but I think that she's somebody who's sincere and doesn't fleece a person. But apart from that, evaluate academies and evaluate makeup artists in other cities, I don't know how, you have to be very careful because you'll end up spending 3 to 5 lakhs And it's not like you're going to get that money, in a month's time, recover that money in a month's time. So you have to be careful. Okay, so that is just some information I wanted to put out there because that's a question that comes quite often. But appo njan avade poi tirichu vannu, it was just 4 weeks of being in Bombay, came back, but I knew this is what I wanted to do. So I just went for it. I just essentially taught myself how to do makeup. Tanyana, most of the skills tanyana padichathu. And I was able to grow my work business on social media. Aa samayathe it was Facebook. I used to just post pictures of my work or I got some members of the family together and I did like their makeup, took pictures, posted it. That's how I got a lot of my initial clients. I think one of the things that I've encountered from when I started doing hair and makeup here is this preoccupation with lightening skin tone, which is something I don't do. And Inikia, I feel all kinds of skin tone are beautiful. And Inikia, I find that very problematic, for me. So there are other artists who lighten skin tone and maybe that is their style, so, but for me, I find that very problematic. So I remember, Nyan, after my second son was born in 2016, I organized a shoot. I got like this, this amazing model and actor came on board. Padam. Can you hear me?
Yes, an amazing model who,
Yeah, Sean Romy, yeah. So she came on board. I got a photographer who's very popular with wedding photography called, Magic Motion Media. It's in the tip of my tongue. I can't remember. That happens to me often. So he came on board and I planned this shoot, and I wanted to showcase that dark skin is beautiful. You don't have to lighten it in order for it to be perceived as attractive. And I wrote, like, I had a little write-up and I put that on my Facebook. And some, like, a journalist happened to, from Manorama, happened to notice that article and she interviewed me. It came in the papers and then slowly, were the Endipati, like people started coming to know about me and also the style of makeup I offer. So yeah, so that those were my beginnings with makeup, and I still maintain that I do not like to lighten skin tone. Appo three up front when clients come to me, I say if they, especially when they come through recommendation, Nyam Bariyam, have you seen my work on Instagram? I would like to tell you at the outset, I will not lighten skin tone. As a matter of principle, I will not do it. If you like this kind of makeup, then if you have no reservations about appearing a bit darker, then we can work. Because it's almost like there's this very real fear, the makeup shouldn't make me look even one shade darker. It's almost like all hell will break loose, So I think where does that idea come from? That korchengum dark aya, that's a that is somehow terrible, So I think that notion of fairness being beautiful and like having dark skin being not attractive is so ingrained and so problematic, so I have lost clients, because I say this at the outset and I lose work because of that. But this is just how I want to work because that's the only thing that gives me a sense of satisfaction, like I want my work to be meaningful. Yes, I want it to earn an income, but I also want it to be meaningful and I also want to create a change in the mindset, so of the people I work with or just the people who discover my work, develop a different kind of appreciation for beauty and all kinds of beauty. Pinne,
Yeah, I
I've
think
also
one of the most beautiful thing which I loved about you
Yeah.
within this 5 to 10 minutes is the transparency that you have. You are not being saying that I've done two courses and both were really wonderful. You said very honestly that one was good, the other one was just a flop. So don't
Yeah.
spend money. Don't
Yeah.
waste your money somewhere there, which is so honest answer one. Second is that you yourself said that you are a self-skilled person, that I believe that people doesn't actually say this. They actually say the academy name or the place from there they have done the course and things. But you said that I've done by my own, and you have been recognized by your work itself. And I'm sure that it's all the word of mouth which actually gets as a reference for you. Second, and the third one is that I love the statement that every complexion has its own beauty, and rather than having the lightening part of a skin, I am so much fixed with my kind of work, and I'll tell my clients that if you want, I'll be doing only this way. If not, it's perfectly fine. I think that is a unique part about you. I think, Priya, when I went through your page, I could see that the N number of things which you have done and the makeups, it actually stands out without, in a simple Malayalam word, I would say is that putti itta mari allade valare sadharana adhe pole thane adhe oru makeover nadathi allengil idu kaiyumba chile veettaru parayilla ayyo ende moola evada poi ennokke choichu chile situation okke undu idu endakke pole ennokke parnadu so that elegance that you actually maintain is wonderful.
Yeah, so it's like I'm not dissing the people who do another style of makeup. That is one style, you know, but yan brides na offeri enna makeover alla. I want brides to look like themselves. I love playing around with makeup now. Adhe pore wedding function allenge or it's some other thing, I'm very happy to experiment, you know, with how makeup is done and make it white, quite wild, give heavy coverage. Like experimentation is great. I just feel brides who would work kiumbo, I feel like on that day it should showcase the best version of themselves, you know. And they should have confidence in how they naturally look, just enhanced. But that is the style I offer, but I, that is not to say that heavy coverage is bad, you know. That is just some other artists offer other styles, you know, but this is my style, you know. So
this is Priya's style. നമ്മുടെ ഒരു കസ്തൂരിമാൻ സിനിമയിലെ ഇതൊക്കെ തുന്നിക്കൂട്ടി പിടിച്ചു വെക്കുമ്പോ ഇത് പ്രിയംവദ സ്റ്റൈലിൽ വന്ന മാതിരി ഇറ്റ്സ് ലൈക്ക് തിങ്സ് വെച്ചിട്ട് ഇറ്റ്സ് ലൈക്ക് പ്രിയ സ്റ്റൈൽ
This is the style that I like to offer brides, but I do like, you know, so I like playing. And there are, okay, there are some, in some case, there are clients who are, I like it to reflect their personality and their character. So some are not, you know, some people don't really wear a lot of makeup. People are not used to seeing them with a lot of makeup on. And they don't feel very comfortable. So then I will work with a look that they feel comfortable with, that, you know, doesn't draw too much of attention, or like, you know, yeah, it looks too, they feel like it's overwhelming for them. But then there are others, you know, there are other people who actually very wildly, I am like one of those persons, I love playing around. So there are sometimes clients like me who love experimenting with makeup and how they look and keep changing their look. And I'm really happy to create a look, you know, we collaborate and create a look that reflects that aspect of their personality, you know. So, and it's, then some people say, oh, I only work with deep skin brides? And I'm just like, have you seen my feed? I work with a range of skin tones. I've also worked with Caucasian brides, you know. So, so it's not like I have some aversion to people who are light skinned. That is not the case at all. You know, like I said, I like all kinds of skin tone, but I do find that people who have deeper skin tone have, there is a stigma attached to, you know, to that, right? To being deeper skinned, or, and that whole notion that's created in our society that deeper skin tones are not beautiful. And that is something I'm working to change in my small way. So, but I do think, like I said, so while I think deep skin is beautiful, I also think pale skin is beautiful and all the different shades in between.
I would definitely recommend the audience to soon after the show to go ahead and check Priya's page, because the word she has used, experiment, you would definitely find it in her page. But to be very honest, she doesn't do experiment most on others, but she does it on herself, which she loves to do. And I was shocked to go and check the page. Okay, now next page, what? So my expressions were actually changing when I went on with every single picture of yours. So now, audience out there, do definitely go and check Priya's page. Soon after the show, you will find the link there, and you will be surprised to know that, okay, now this is the reason why she says it's Priya's style.
Yeah, you know, so I love that. So I think it's so harmless to play, and I wish more people would do it. Both men and women would experiment with how they look. Because I'm like, it's such a personal thing. You just, you know, you don't have to ask for anybody else's consent about how, you know, what you should be doing to yourself. You know, you want a haircut, get a haircut. You want to curl your hair, you know. You want to wear a bright shade of lipstick, do that. You want to play around with makeup, do that. You know, it's play. I think play is very important. And we play a as children, but as we grow, when we grow into adults, we find play hard. A lot of people find play hard, you know, and this is one kind of play, you know, that helps you relax. So it's something that people should try. And I think a lot of people are trying it, which is why you see Instagram has blown up in such a way, big way, right? Or YouTube, because you find people using this as a form of play, you know, like whatever, like, you know, experimenting with hair or experimenting with makeup. You know, or cooking, you know, like trying different kinds of baking. They're all different kinds of play. And I think that it's important when you grow into adults to indulge in some sort of play. So makeup is
okay.
one way of experimenting in play.
Now, I don't know why, but I feel that, are you trying to point me out by saying that, come on, Kirti, you need to probably go ahead and do some other plays as well, because I...
No. Not at all. I think... I just find that because, you know, like, this is something else I've noticed. Ippo ingane brides urunga merumbo, you know, sometimes our mothers are not that very old. They're probably like 10, 15 years older to me. But it's almost like they feel, ivide Keralathil, a lot of women, as they get older, they feel like they have to look old, you know. Yan bride amme alle, appo enikku, I can't look like, I I'm not, like, it's almost like, you know, you cannot look sexy. You know, you can look sexy at any age, you know, you can, you don't, so there are all these notions, which, restrictive notions about how women should be, you know, or like, or the daughter will say, son will say, oh, koodi poya, and I'm like, you know, why do you do that, you know, aren't you policing, you're policing your mother, and that's so, you don't like that being done to you, so why would you do that to your parent, you know, so there are a lot of restrictive ideas, right, around how women should be, you know, and yeah, so I hope that changes, you know, so when I'm in that situation, I'll be like, why not, you know, I'll be like, auntie, you're not that old, you know, you can play around, you don't have to look old, you know, you can, this is your daughter or your son's day, you can look good, you know, it's not a bad thing that, you know, you want, the fact that you even want to look good is not a bad thing at all, you know, you should definitely do this. And how many occasions do you get to play around with hair and makeup? You have an occasion today, do it, you know.
I love that point what you said, Priya, because seriously, Priya, it's an eye-opener for a lot of women around, because as you said, there is a notion that when you're a mother of a bride, you need to be set up like this. But I think now it has been changed a lot. Now people doesn't think too much like as it was earlier. But right now it's being like, when there is a makeup artist for a bride, yes, the mother also gets a bit of touch up. So I think now things are changing a bit. Maybe the upcoming time, the things would turn up into another way where the bride will stay out and the bride's mom will come forward by saying that, don't you think that I look so sexy today?
Why not?
Priya, moving on, Priya, I have to add on one more thing into your profile by saying like a couple of things which I have added there. Your passion towards photography. How did that happen actually? Like a makeup artist into photography again? And that too, very professional photographs.
Thank you. So I'm an amateur. I'm teaching myself, but I love it. So what happened is, like, as I used to take, you know, I would ask brides, right, please send me your professionally shot pictures, and they would be delayed, or they would, you know, I would get some pictures, they'd be really beautiful, but it won't be very indicative of how I'd done the makeup, because all, again, you know, makeup photographers have their own styles of taking photographs, they work with different kinds of lighting, they also edit the pictures, there are different tones that are used. So while the pictures are beautiful, it wouldn't really showcase my work the way I had done it, you know, on the day. So that's how I started taking pictures on my own. So I invested in a camera and I said, okay, let me just start taking pictures of the bride on the day itself, so I don't have to pester them. If they send the pictures, that's great. If they don't, I have these pictures for my portfolio and it showcases the work the way I see it, the way I see I've done it, you know. So that's how it started. And I really enjoy taking pictures of women, you know, and I thought, okay, I really want to be doing more of this. So in 2018, I went and, like, you get lenses on hire. So for portraiture, you require some types of lenses. So I went and borrowed a lens and I shot like this actor called Lakshmi Menon, you know, she's a Malayali, but she's more in Tamil films. And she had approached me for something, and you know, like she had actually approached me to do some styling for her, like to help do personal shopping for her. And then I decided to take some pictures with the clothes that we had shopped for together. And I realized I really loved it. You know, I was so much in my element doing it. And then I think I just had like some more sessions in 2018. No, was it 2008? No, 2019. And then, of course, in 2020, we, you know, the pandemic happened and we went into lockdown. But it was, you know, I was like, I really want to do this. So I went and bought a lens online. I found an affordable lens, and these lenses are quite expensive. So I found a lens, and then I started doing self-portraits, you know. So, and I figured that out, and I started playing around with that through the last year, the lockdown last year, like, you know, last year, in June, July, you know, July, I think. And then I had this photographer, this girl, she was chatting with me, and she said, Priya, will you take some pictures of me? And I said, okay, why not, you know. So she came over on a Sunday, and I shot some pictures of her, and then I was so excited. I ended up editing. I mean, I would have shot hundreds of pictures, you know. But by the end of the day, I'd shortlisted the pictures, I'd edited the pictures, and I'd posted them online. You know, I'd done some mild corrections and posted it online. And I loved it. I was like literally like work like a machine. I didn't want to eat, didn't want to drink. I just wanted to kind of like, you know, post the pictures. So and I got a lot of good feedback. And then I started doing these sessions every Sunday. So last year I did that September, October. You know, I started, more and more women started approaching me and saying, can you shoot us? Can you shoot us? So there are some people, women, till now I haven't shot them, and they were, you know, they must be thinking, jade, Anna. Like, but life also happens, and I'm also a mom. You know, I also went through a divorce, you know, so all of that happened through the pandemic. So I was going through quite a lot of difficult experiences, and it's amidst that actually photography also, I did photography, you know, because it was giving me meaning, it was giving me purpose, it was, you know, it was making me happy doing it, you know. So, yeah, so that's how photography, yeah, that's how it, like, I would say, got, yeah, that's my journey.
So I think, Priya, you started by saying that creativity was something always with you. So, in one or the other way, it always just came up on your way, and you actually took it up rather than, and I have seen a lot of people just saying that, okay, now this is not possible for me, rather than trying it out at least for once. They just ignore it. But I think you have just explored, as you say. I think the word which suits you the best, or an adjective which I would definitely love to give you, is a play Priya, like someone who always play around with a lot of, you know, experiments and explore things and always try it out. I think that's the best thing which is about you.
I don't, you know, so I feel a lot of the limitations you said, no, beyond the limits, right? Like evoke, that was just at that. But a lot of the limitations we place are, you know, we place it on ourselves, you know. So yes, society places limitations on you and your family and your responsibilities, but we also place a lot of limitations on ourselves, which is if we kind of stop doing that, then, you know, because you're like, oh, what will the family say, what will, you know, we always put the often it's easier to put the, like, you know, put that responsibility on something outside of us, you know. We also have to kind of look at, are we doing this to ourselves, you know, and why are we doing it to ourselves? Because we're afraid that you know, what if I fail, you know, then what will people say to me? Or if what I turn out isn't good enough, then what will people say? We're so scared of judgment, failure, judgment. You know, so we then, you don't even try, you know. So in my case, I'm not afraid of failure. And I've come to this point in my life where I'm not like as afraid of judgment either. I mean, of course, it will hurt when you don't get positive feedback or whatever, you know, but it's a process, you know. It's like, it's a process of learning, you know, to accept yourself and learning to, you know. Yeah, so obviously we are not, you know, we are not these supernatural beings. Of course, sometimes criticism can be painful, but I think that also in some ways pushes you to see what you can do better, or rather pushes me to see what I can do better.
Very true. Priya, moving on, one more thing which I have added up about the, you know, advocacy as well. Would you mind to just share that also with us? What exactly it is? What are you really doing? and a few more light to that point of it.
Sure. അപ്പൊ ഞാൻ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ ഞാൻ തുടങ്ങിയപ്പോ വെൻ ഐ സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ഡൂയിങ് ഹെയർ ആൻഡ് മേക്കപ്പ് ഫോർ മീ അറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് പോയിന്റ് ഇൻ ടൈം വാട്ട് ഐ ഒബ്സർവ്ഡ് വാസ് കളറിസം യു നോ കളറിസം ഇസ് വെരി വെരി ഇൻഗ്രെയിൻഡ് ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യൻ സൊസൈറ്റി ആൻഡ് ഇൻഗ്രെയിൻഡ് ഇൻ ലൈക് കേരള നമ്മുടെ മലയാളി ലൈക് അമിഡ്സ്റ്റ് അസ് യു നോ ആൻഡ് എസ്പെഷ്യലി സോ ദാറ്റ് വാസ് ഡ്രോയിങ് അറ്റൻഷൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് സ്റ്റിൽ വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് ഫോർ മീ You know, you will see on my feed, even with the shoots I've done, I've worked with some really deep-skinned and gorgeous women to just showcase. For me, I just see, I don't know what others see, but I see beauty, you know. So, if you go through my highlights also, there's one called Melanin. So, it's just showcasing a lot of deep skin and a lot of it is, you know, they're of African descent, right? They're African people. Because they are on the darkest end of the, you know, like in terms of skin, like they have the darkest skin tones. So I feel like just putting those images out there on social media makes people start appreciating that. Do you understand?
Yeah.
You start appreciating what you see more of. Kandilenia, it is not even within, you know, it's not, those images are not even in your mind, you know, as you don't. But the more you see it, the more you develop an appreciation for it. So, which is why I like to populate my stories or my feed with pictures of deeper skinned people, you know, women. Because I do know I've had some brides come and tell me, you know, in some other makeup artist's feed, they don't post their deep skinned brides. Now, ore picture ang kaanilla, somebody who is deep skinned. And I found that quite. You know, I was like, wow, is that the case? And I saw in a lot of feeds, like sometimes they don't post some of their deeper skin brides, you know. So I was like, I'm not going to do that. You know, all my brides are going to appear on my feed, you know. So, and they're all beautiful and they will appear on my feed, one. And then, of course, you know, just posting pictures of Ingenes. So that I do that on my stories, I do that. So colorism is very important, like drawing attention to that and questioning that and trying in my small way to change people's thoughts about what beauty is. Pinne, feminism. I've always been a feminist. I think even before I recognized the term feminist, I think as a child I was a feminist, you know, so so that's very important for me. And it's really about what is feminism is really for just where women are treated equally, you know, in society, where we're not seen as like a lesser beings, you know. And so, you know, again, I post that on my stories, you know, I post. So a lot of there are, you know, so there are Instagram accounts already out there, right, that are that memes, your feminist memes, or they. You know, they talk about it like it's dedicated to feminism. So in my, what I do, I think, is amplify that. I amplify those feeds. Okay, I have an 8,000 strong audience. I don't know how many of them engage with my feed on a daily basis, but I can amplify these accounts, right? I can't do everything, but I can. It's also, you know, let's amplify the people who are doing it, right? So let's, so that's what I do. So I amplify those, you know, I express my own ideas or ideas that I relate to, and I post that, I mean, you know, on my stories. So a lot of my advocacy happens on my stories. A lot of what, you know, my personal belief systems, all that I share in my stories, and some of it finds its way into my highlights. So if you look on my Instagram highlights, the main feed will showcase my photography, my brides, in my reels now I'm playing around a little bit with, you know, I still don't know, I haven't really cracked it as yet, but I have some fun with my reels, but and the advocacy happens on my stories. So there's colorism, there is feminism. I talk about motherhood and a new definition for motherhood, like because who I am as a mother is very, very different from what my mother was to me. And I think that's a challenge a lot of women in my generation face, you know, because we find ourselves to be mothering quite differently to how our mothers were. And sometimes you're questioning yourself, you know, or you have doubts, you know, or there's guilt. Should I, this is this, you know, is this the way to do it? And, so I kind of, again, I, share those stories on so show share that in my stories, you know, about motherhood, a new idea of motherhood, you know, a motherhood where we are not like martyring ourselves. We're giving ourselves time, you know, to do things for ourselves, to you know, to love ourselves, to forgive ourselves when we fail. I think that's really important, you know. So those experiences, you know, so the advocacy happens in that part. What else do I talk about? I talk about LGBTQ, right? Like, you know, gender being a spectrum and not just black and white, male and female, you know, like man and woman. I talk about that. I've recently been drawing attention to that. So that's something I do. I talk about mental health. Yeah, mental and emotional wellness. And these, you know, so these are not like arbitrary things that I just pull out from it. It's also my personal experience. It is what moves me. It is part of my lived experience, and therefore I share it. So it's not like some, oh, you know, suddenly I'm interested in this, so I'll pick it up from here and pick it up from there. No, it's my lived experience. It's what I encounter on a daily basis, and therefore it finds its way into my stories. So I think, you know, mental and emotional wellness has been stigmatized for so long, right, talking about it. And I want to normalize, you know, talking about mental and emotional health and also seeking therapy. So you don't just seek therapy when you have a problem in your relationships, either with your partner or, you know, with bringing up a child or just with yourself. You know, if you do ongoing therapy, I think, because we all suffer from varying degrees of childhood trauma. And I think that has an effect in how we relate to people as we get older and how we parent. And I think in therapy, you can heal and you can develop strengths you thought you never had. You can dig into reserves of patience you thought you never had. And so I think therapy is very, very essential for everybody, you know. I think, okay, like, you know, there are some people who may have severe mental health conditions and they probably need psychiatric help, they need medication. But therapy is something, you know, which I think all human beings need, you know. I think in order to lead more fulfilling, richer lives and really know how to experience the full breadth of emotion without shame. You know, others people have so much of shame about dealing with anger or outbursts of anger or sadness. They feel like you're not allowed to do that. You should just like smile through all of life, and that's impossible, you know. I think our, you know, humanity is defined by a breadth, like of human emotion: anger, sadness, shame, guilt, happiness, sorrow, grief. There's just a whole breadth of them, and I think in therapy you learn how to manage all of those emotions, you know, integrate all of those emotions. So I think therapy is very, very useful. So I post about that. I also share numbers or contact details of therapists, you know, who I actually crowdsourced a list from my Instagram followers, and it's there again on my highlights, you know. So that's something else I talk about. So that's what I do with advocacy, you know. So. Yeah.
Priya, usually what happens is that when we have got a lot of things, we say that, you know, there is an umbrella word or an umbrella term under which we can put all this. Now, I would definitely say all this come under one umbrella term, which is Priya.
Yeah,
so what not are you doing? Yeah, and I need to probably say, what not are you doing? And I feel so proud about you, Priya, because you know why? These are all a lot of inspiration for a lot of women around, I believe, because women always think, I believe, in general, that we cannot manage everything together. And I'm sure that people might be wondering, like, okay, now you're doing a lot of things. How do you manage this? Or maybe you have got a lot of people around you to help you out. But Priya, whom I know, I think that it's not like that. You manage by yourself every single thing. But it is all about how do you prioritize and how do you actually manage things in a better way. And one more thing which I would like to add up is that it's not all about doing 100% perfect on whatever you do. But you at least do things in the right way, which you feel is a... No, the best out of it.
Yeah.
So it's wonderful.
Yeah. So I had somebody tell me, somebody close to me said, you know, you spread yourself too thin. What they meant is like you're involved in too many things, you know. So I was just like, but it makes ha me happy to be that way, you know. So I'm still being authentic, you know. So I like, for there is no method to my madness on my Instagram. So I don't see myself as a social media influencer. I don't churn out content in like with a timeline, you know. So I have to turn, you know, once a week I have to do this kind of thing, once a week I have to do that, or you know, I'm not bound by any of those you know, like social media best practices, let's say. I don't know, like I'm not an influencer. I don't see myself as an influencer, so I don't have any method. What you get over there on my Instagram is really a slice of me, and I mean, I don't want to share all of me. I mean, some things are deeply personal, but what you do get is a very authentic, you know, slice of a version of me, you know. And I do share the personal element because I know that there are a lot of women like me, you know, who are having similar struggles, similar questions, you know, some of them are just waiting for inspiration, right, to kind of do something. So I think when we're honest and you kind of speak out, then women connect, people connect, you know. So yeah, that's important for me. I mean, that's just who I am. I don't know how to
Priya,
be
what
otherwise.
comes to my mind right now is that the day when I spoke to you for the first time on call to discuss about inviting you to the show, you asked me one thing that, but what am I going to talk about? Are you serious that you want me to come here? I'm not an influencer, and what else should I talk? So right now, and I'm sure that the entire audience out there who is watching your show or like the episode right now, or the first people who those who would be watching it later on would definitely say that it was the right piece of cake which we had tonight, because it was a junk or a pool of a lot of things we have discussed where people need to actually start thinking about it. Every time I used to ask my guests that what is the message from their side by the end of the episode, but I think every single word which you were saying in some or the other way, at least for me, it was a lot of rethinking, like, wow, you've got to do a lot of things rather than sitting idle. You need to get yourself engaged a lot so that you're mentally and physically you become more active, as which you are right now. So I feel so proud and happy that I have invited you for this episode to share your
Thank you.
story, and
Thank
it's
you
so
so much.
beautiful to
Thank
know.
you. I just hope, you know, even it makes a difference to at least one person, you know, inspires them to do something for themselves, you know. Because as women, we're always told to put somebody else, you know, make other people priority and not ourselves, you know. So I just hope this inspires somebody to do something for themselves. Because I think when we are fulfilled and we love ourselves, we're able to love others better. Or even we're able to love others. You know, if you're not able to love yourself, it's hard. How do you give out of what you don't have? So when you learn how to tend to yourself with care and with forgiveness and with love, you're able to do it for others too. You treat with them with the same amount of care, you know. So
Very true. I don't know, Priya, should I ask you the routine question, and is there a message from your side? I doubt if the audience might say, now what else message do you want? Because she's been telling everything as a message. But still, as a part of the formality, I may probably have to ask, like, Priya, is there any more messages that you would like to add up to this particular episode?
Be fearless, ladies. Be fearless, you know. If you want to see it, be the change you want to see. You know, like if you want you know, the society here in Kerala to treat you differently, you be different. You know, you want, instead of saying either in a narkilya, idi vida narkilya, you are the person who can make that change. So be that change. That's it.
Thank you so much, Priya. It was wonderful having you here once again. Great to see you here. Great to talk to you and share your story with the audience out there. I'm sure that it would have definitely been an inspiration for a lot of people around there to go ahead and do a lot of things, be fearless and play around with things. These are the words which I am taking along with me after this episode. So once again, with the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for being a part of this episode.
Thank you for having me, you know. Thank you for giving me this platform, and I thank you so much. I wish you the very best.
Thank you so much. And to the audience out there, thank you so much, people, for being a part of this episode. You have always been with us from the first episode till when we complete our 54th episode. So keep supporting Beautiful Minds. Next weekend, you will have another wonderful lady with me sharing her own story with us. So right now, at this point, we only have a few things to say. Keep smiling, stay safe at home, and have a great evening ahead. Thank you so much, Priya, once again.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.